looking for my destination, nowhere near the journey's end. I can see we're on this ship together, just holding on, 'cause help is on the way.
Hello there.
Hello.
Aren't you gonna play this song with me?
No, we're not.
And I know the dawn will find us like the morning greets the day. And though the slow boat comes in last, it lasts forever. It's holding on, 'cause help is on the way. On the way, it's all of the feelings inside me, and when it comes, it's gonna guide me home. I know, keep holding on, 'cause help is on the way, and when I see him there beside me, reaching up to touch the sky, then I know I'm not alone. We're on this road together, just holding on, 'cause help is on the way. When it comes, it's gonna guide me home. I know, keep holding on, help is on the way. All right, here we go. Yes! Help is on the way. It's all of the feeling inside me. And when it comes, is gonna guide me home. I know, holding on, God help me, God help on the way. It's on the
help is here, so we're going to proceed with this evening's activities.
Sounds like a why.
Well, I love you too a lot. So we're going to proceed with this evening's activities. We're going to start off with a song written by a girlfriend of mine and myself. My girlfriend's name is Carol Sager, and the name of this tune is Midnight Blue.
One more time. you told me you need me. Needing me now is something I could use. Midnight blue, wouldn't you give your hand to a friend? Maybe it's not the end, and I think we can make it one more time if we try. One more time for all the old times. Midnight blue. One more time. I think we can make it. Try. I think we can make it. If we try.
Change to me. Now that's the name. Yeah. That's the name of the key sermonette of the church that I happen to be a founding member of. The church that I happen to be a founding member of is called the Church of Self-Realization and a Hop Diggity Dog. Oh, I have a higher change to me. Whoa, 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 yes. And the one thing you taught me clearly to see. Is that the miracle is in my soul? Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Oh, heaven, how you changed me. Whoa, 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 whoa. And the one thing you taught me clearly to see is that the miracle is in my soul.
One more once.
Oh, heaven, how you changed me. Whoa, 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 whoa. And the one thing you taught me clearly to see is that the miracle is in my soul.
I used to dream of heaven as the home of the final down. If you were good, you went to a heaven. And if you were bad, you went to town. I used to see a heaven as a snow kingdom, cold as lead. Sickly sweet angels were there to greet me. They put a bad number on my head, so I said,
oh, heaven, how you changed me. Whoa, 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 whoa. And the one thing you taught me clearly to see is that the miracle is in my soul.
I was a fool, turned sinner, and delighted to be known as
one. I want what I use and live in goodness. But being bad was much more fun. I had a soul on fire. I put the passions of the mind to shame. And all the time, a voice that whispered, kid, come here. You're playing with the devil's game. So I said,
some people call a racket. Some people call it a calling. Hello, busy. It's hard to make friends. It's even hard to hold on to friends. And that's because usually when I'm checking into town, most of my friends are checking out of town. So how do you make friends? How do you hold on to friends? Well, you exchange phone numbers, see, and you say things like, we must get together sometime. But you never have time to get together. But there was this one day, see, when I was straightening up my kitchen. It's hard to believe, but I was straightening up my kitchen and I came across all these matchbooks and grocery lists where I'd written these phone numbers that I'd collected over the years. So I come across the phone number of Kenny Loggins and I gave him a buzz and I said, Kenny, yes. I said, Kenny, you want to write a song or what? And he said, yes, ma'am. So he came over to my house and brought this very large bottle of wine and I drank most of it. But we wrote this song that night. That's it.
I believe I've come to her. whiskey anywhere we are. You and I will always be forever and ever.
I'll think about the times to come, knowing I will be the lucky one. Ever I'll ever last, I always want to call you friend. Sweet love showing us a heavenly light. I've never seen such a beautiful sight. See love glowing on us every night. I know forever we'll keep doing it.
You want to dance?
I'd vote for that couple in any dance contest.
Regular Fred and Ethel.
Ethel, yeah.
Whenever I call you friend,
you're my friend.
You're my friend. Oh, baby, yeah. And now I know my life is giving me more than memories.
Day by day, we can see.
And
such a beautiful sight.
Still love flowing on us every night. I know forever we'll keep doing it, doing it. Sweet love showing us a heavenly light. I never seen such a beautiful sight. Still love flowing on us every night. I know forever we'll keep doing it, doing it, doing it.
This next song we're about to do, I had the opportunity of working for the first time with a gentleman who I think is a remarkable lyricist, and I think most of you will know him by name. His name is Bernie Taupin. This is the title cut from our new album. I work in the chorus doing three shows a night, wearing fishnets and feathers under blinding white lights. I've served shorts to hard hats who had booze on their lips, been fondled and leered at for an occasional tip. The working girl's world is the size of her purse. From Detroit to Des Moines is the same ugly scene. I'm a cog, you're a wheel, he's a king, she's a queen. From the smokestacks to the meat racks where you're sweating for sweet water just run through your hands. Six kids in Cleveland from one wedding band. Tied up to a mail loom for the minimum wage. A nest egg's a daydream that never gets laid. And it Just met, but I told you a little bit about this and a little bit about that, that I've been working on my penmanship, writing tunes, straightening my kitchen, but I'm also a singer, you know, and I think one of the great joys of being a singer is to find a really great song and to sing it, and even if it's been sung a million times before, I say to that, sing it again, Sam. You must remember this. A kiss is just a kiss. A sigh is still a sigh. The fundamental things apply as time goes by. Went to lover's room. They still say, I love you. On that you can rely. No matter what the future brings, time goes by. Moonlight and love songs, never out of date. Hearts filled with passion, jealousy and hate. Woman needs man, and man must have his mate. That no one can deny. On that you can rely. It's still the same old story. A fight for love and glory. Okay. Do or die. The world will always welcome lovers as time.
listen.
It's all in the sky above. It's all in the earth below. Everything you've heard about, everything you need to know, it's all in the friends you love. You know, long before I started writing with Bernie Taupin or Kenny Loggins or any of those folks, I used to write a lot of songs by myself, you know? And I'd sit at a piano just like this. Perhaps not anything like this. My piano defined the word funk, you know? It had a couple of cigarette burns over there and some initials carved in the bottom. They were my initials just hanging out there. And it glowed in the dark. Hello. But I never felt lonely at the piano because the music was always keeping me company. So I wrote my little songs, you know? And around the same time, I got a chance to meet another songwriter by the name of Carol Bayer Sager. Oh yeah, I think so. When Carol and I decided to get together to write for the first time, I went over to her house. I always go over to the other person's house when we're deciding to write for the first time, because to me, writing is so, it's so personal, you know? That I always go over to the other person's house because just in case we're not having a good time, I get a chance to make the excuse to leave. But we were having a great time that day. First of all, you have to understand, Carol lived in a typical New York apartment, which means it's as small as you can get it and as dark as you can make it because there's a panoramic view of the next building. So. But we were having a bang-up time just yakking and schmoozing and gabbing away, which is how we write, start all of our writing sessions. Sometimes we never get to the writing because we're yakking and schmoozing and gabbing away. But I finally turned to her and I said, Carol, how are you? And fortunately, she did not say fine. So we were off and running, and naturally we talked about what was not fine, and things we were going through, why other people were going through things and leaving us out of it. That was about 10 years ago. Now when we get together to write, we've even discussed the fact that our friendship has lasted longer than both of our marriages. Anyway, so at the time, meanwhile, we talked about mostly the difference between being alone and being lonely. You know, on one hand, alone, and on the other hand, lonely. I wake up and see the light of the day shining on me. Make my own time. It's mine to spend. Talk to myself, my own best friend. It's not so bad all alone, coming home to myself again. Now, somehow I know I've come a long way. Got a long way to go, but something inside is making me strong. And in the bad times, I'll get along, 'cause it's not so bad all alone, coming home to myself again. And that was just about the first song that Carol and I ever wrote. And what happened with that song, you see, when our friends heard that song, and they heard how easy it was for us to be alone by ourselves, and how terrific we were supposed to be when we were alone by ourselves, and how together we were supposed to be when we were alone by ourselves, then all of our friends that couldn't stand being alone by themselves want to be alone with us by ourselves. And when you're trying to write a song that makes for an awful lot of interruptions, but an interesting idea for a song. Got a house on the hill, and it's constantly filled with a number of passing acquaintances. But I'm tired and spent from all the friendships well meant. But the rent's getting high on my maintenance, Lord. So why should I care about leaving them there when nobody's home when you need them? Even after you love them and feed them.
Oh, Lord.
Say, do not disturb me. This lady's not home today. Remember, Missy loves you. Oh, but please do not disturb me. This lady's not home today. And that song was on my third record album, so how bad could things be, right? And we were no longer writing in a small, dark, steam-heated New York apartment. No, now we were poolside in Beverly Hills, a hot sea and totsy. And after our morning yoga and granola lessons, I turned to her and I said, Carol, how are you? And still, she did not say, fine. So we tried kicking around simpler questions, you know? Like, what is the difference between falling in love and being in love? Lying by your side, just another night. Hear the clock that's ticking on the wall. Long ago, we never heard it at all. Another real simple one we kicked around was, why is it that the first 2 weeks of love are always so filled with and did you ever notice how by the second year there seems to be an awful lot of no more nights of lace. Flannel takes its place. Feeling like I should be feeling more. What love is, I tell you, I don't know. I don't know, I don't know. Maybe that's the whole point. Maybe if Carol and I ever figured out what love is, or what love was, or what love could be, we wouldn't have anything to write another song about. I'm not sure about that. But I do remember there was one day. It was about 15 minutes, but they were happy. And I turned to her and I said, Carol, how are you? And she actually said, fine. Let's hear some good news for the lady. She's coming up from far behind. And if she seems a little slow, it only goes to show that everything will grow in its own time. And so I hope you'll understand that I can't always join the band you play in. And if I hide behind the words I'm saying, she takes the time to pause, just give her room, because she'll be coming round the mountain in her time. You know everything will grow in its own time. Well, I tell you, I don't know if it's because we're two women who write together, or more so because we're two friends that have shared so many similar experiences that make us write the kind of songs that we write. But I'll tell you one thing. I figure that the songs that Carol Sager and I write are like a guidebook to mental health. Because the songs continue to be healthier than we could ever hope to be. But I know that the really wonderful thing about writing is that you get a chance to share secrets, you know? And feel like you're not going crazy all by yourself. And the other wonderful thing about this whole deal is that I get a chance to be invited here and sing a song for you that I happen to love. So, if you want me, you can have me. And if you need me, I'll be there. I'm not playing hard to get, oh no. I haven't turned you down yet, whoa, whoa. And if you're ready, I'm set to go anywhere, anywhere. I just want you to want me. Come on, come on, come on, come on and love me. Come on, come on, come on, come on. 'Cause babe, can't you see? There's nothing harder than to live without love. That's why they call me easy. If you're feeling kind of low, come on over and stay at my place. I got music that's mingled with lace. I'll never be the one to tell you it's time to go. I just want you to want me. Come on now. Come on, come on, come on, come on and love me. Can you do that? Come on, come on, come on, come on. Cause where can't you see? There's nothing harder than to live without love. That's why they call me easy. Easy. Come and call me easy.
easy. Yes.
Baby cried the day the circus came to town, 'cause she didn't want parades just passing by her. So she painted on a smile and took up with some clown, while she danced without a net up on the wire. I know a lot about her, 'cause you see, baby is an awful lot like me. Don't cry out loud, just keep it inside. Learn how to hide your feelings. you almost had it all. Baby saw that when they pulled that big top down, they left behind her dreams among the litter, and that different kind of love she thought she found. There was nothing left but sawdust and some glitter. But baby can't be broken, 'cause you see, she had the finest teacher, that was me. I told her, don't cry out loud, just keep it inside and learn how to hide your feelings. Fly high and proud, and if you should fall, remember you almost had it all. Don't cry out loud, just keep
Yes, I think so.
The moment I saw him smile, I knew he was just my style. My only regret is we've never met, though I think of him all the while. But he doesn't know I exist, no matter how I may persist. So it's clear to see there's no hope for me. Though I live at 5135 Kensington Avenue, and he lives at 5133. can I ignore the boy next door? I love him more than I can say. Doesn't try to please me, doesn't even tease me, and he never sees me glance his way. And though I'm heart sore, the boy next door affections for me won't display. I just adore him. So I can't ignore him, the boy.
That was one of Judy Garland's most famous songs. And to me, she was it. And maybe if she were alive today, maybe she would have sung this song of mine.
Well, hello there, good old friend of mine. You've been reaching for yourself for such a long time. There's so much to say, no need to explain. Just an open door for you to come in from the rain. It's a long road when you're all alone, and someone like you will always choose the long way home. There's no right or wrong, I'm not here to blame. I just want to be the one to keep you from the rain, from the rain. Sunny skies. Now that I know you're all right, time has left us older and wiser. I know I think of us like an old cliche, but it doesn't matter, 'cause I love you anyway. Come in from the rain, and it looks like sunny skies. Now that I know you're older but wiser, I know I am. and it's good to know my best friend has come home again. 'Cause I think of us like an old cliche, but it doesn't matter, 'cause I love you anyway. Hey!